Hello everyone, in this video I'll be explaining about the overview of cellular respiration. Expect another video where I explain the details of cellular respiration later. We all know that cellular respiration is the process where living organisms break down food to produce energy, and food is usually glucose, because whatever we eat will eventually become glucose if it gives energy. If cellular respiration happens in all living things, it happens in animals, it happens also in plants. The only difference between animal and plants is that plants make their own food by photosynthesis, then they might use that food in cellular respiration. We cannot make our own food. That's why we need to search for the food. Then we get to do cellular respiration. Just like photosynthesis, cellular respiration, if you notice the equation here, it shows that it's kind of the exact opposite of of photosynthesis. It starts off with glucose, C6H12O6 plus oxygen, and it gives off as waste CO2, a bit of water, and the energy. And here, of course, the energy will be in the form of ATP, and we will see that one glucose molecule will give around 36 to 38 ATP. Where does the glucose come from? Well, for example, in us, we eat the food, we digest the food. In the small intestine, the food gets absorbed into the blood, and then the blood will take the glucose into every single cell of our body. Any cell that needs energy will take in this glucose, along with the oxygen delivered also by the blood, to do this process to make energy, so that they use the energy. And the oxygen, of course, comes from the lungs. We breathe in the air from the outside. The oxygen diffuses into the blood, and then the blood takes it to all the cells of the body, where it diffuses out of the blood into the cells of the body. The CO2 does the same path, but the opposite way of oxygen. H2O is produced. Well, we always need H2O, and of course it will be used by the body. But the ones produced here are not enough. That's why we still need to drink water. And ATP, or the energy, is used wherever it's needed in the cell. We might have building molecules, whole cell transport, active transport, the cell itself moving, digesting, moving stuff inside it, plenty of things, muscles contracting, they all need ATP. Before we go to the process, the overview of the process, I'll talk about the structure of the mitochondria, because the major part of cellular respiration happens in the mitochondria. So just a brief view of the structure of the mitochondria. The mitochondria, you should know that it's an organelle in the cells. It has two membranes, an outer membrane and an inner membrane. The inner membrane is folded to the inside, as you can see here and here. And the outer membrane is not folded. The folds of the inner membrane gives it more surface area, so more enzymes, more proteins are put in that membrane, so more processes can happen in a certain amount of time. Each fold of them is called cristae, as you can see here. So the folds to the inside are called cristae, and you would be having here what we call the intermembranar space, which is between the two membrane, and the inside is called the matrix, which is all that fluid in the inside between the folds. So here it looks this blue fluid that they showed here, that's the matrix. Okay, some of the steps happen in the matrix, some of the steps happen in the folds in the inner membrane, and some of the steps in cell respiration we'll see they happen in the cytoplasm outside. To get to the steps of cellular respiration, it happens in 3 to 4 steps. In the overview, I'll just talk about 3 steps. In the detailed view, in the other video, I'll talk about the 4th step, which lies between these two, called link reaction. Anyway, the first step is glycolysis. Glycolysis will take this glucose taken from the blood, and will start the process of breaking down that glucose. It happens in the cytoplasm. So here we're still in the cytoplasm, we didn't get to the mitochondria, and the glycolysis is called an anaerobic process because it doesn't use oxygen here. Oxygen is used later on. Glucose will be broken down into pyruvate, two molecules of pyruvate, which are three carbon molecules, so each glucose breaks into two. This breaking down, or this glycolysis, will give us electrons in the electron carrier NADH, and will give us a bit of ATP. ATP, of course, that's the reason we're making the whole process to get energy. So the ATP will go and will be used wherever it's needed to be used. The NADH now, we will see later what will happen with it. Here there's a process called link reaction. I won't talk about it a lot, but the CO2 given off is given off in the link reaction, and even this link reaction gives more NADH here. Anyway, the link reaction will transform pyruvate into another substance, which will be able to go into the second step, or the third step, if you want to call it, which is the Krebs cycle, or sometimes called citric acid cycle. It happens in the matrix of the mitochondria. It's a cycle, so it ends where it started, and it releases a lot of CO2. It's just the breaking down of more breaking down of glucose until we release all the CO2. So all the carbons that we've taken in are released there. This release, this breaking down, will gain us energy, will give us energy in the form of ATP, a bit of ATP, which will be used, and other electron carriers such as NADH and FADH2. I'm not going into the numbers now because we'll see them in the other video. Okay, the amount of ATP produced till now is still not much for one glucose molecule. So now comes the role for these electron carriers that we've been producing here and in the link reaction and in the Krebs cycle. All of them will go, as you can see from the arrows, will go to the last step, third step, which is the ETC, electron transport chain. This is similar to the electron transport chain in the photosynthesis, and you will see that it does the same. What happens in it is very similar to that. It happens in the inner membrane, so in the cristae we have all those proteins for it. Here oxygen is used, so oxygen is used only for this step, and water is produced, just the opposite of photosynthesis where water produces oxygen, but here is the opposite case. And this step will give us much more ATP using these electron carriers, which will deliver their electrons into the electron transport chain. So we get a lot of ATPs here. And of course, this is the reason we got ATP, we got water, we used oxygen, we got a lot of CO2, 6 CO2, and we used the glucose. So we've used every part of the reaction in the beginning. Just a quick view about what we call fermentation or anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration happens in us and other organisms like bacteria or yeast. You have two types of anaerobic respiration. It's either lactic acid fermentation, it's the same thing, fermentation, or anaerobic respiration. Lactic acid. The lactic acid is example what happens in us when there isn't enough oxygen being given to our muscles and we're exercising a lot. So our muscle cells switch to a plan B instead of shutting off the cell respiration and the muscle will stop working because there isn't enough oxygen. They switch into plan B, which is lactic acid fermentation. They use glucose and they do glycolysis into pyruvate, which gains them 2 ATP. And here the pyruvate is turned back into lactic acid because we cannot keep pyruvate as it is. This lactic acid will start to build in our muscle, and that's what will cause cramps. This happens also in bacteria. The one that makes yogurt, it does the same thing and makes lactic acid, which which transforms milk into yogurt. The other type of fermentation happens in yeast, and it's alcoholic fermentation, where the same thing happens. So these organisms, alcoholic, they do not have mitochondria, the yeast, the bacteria. That's why they only do glycolysis. So from glucose to pyruvate, and they get the 2 ATP, and they're just happy with it. That's how they live. And the pyruvate, they change it into ethanol, and the ethanol is released outside as alcohol. Some humans would use it. This is how they make alcohol out of sugars like grapes or others. So this is either in organisms that just do not use oxygen, they are not adapted to use oxygen, or in organisms like us where it happens because there isn't enough oxygen. So it's better to form only 2 ATP rather than shutting off the whole process. And of course we'll reach a point where there's too much lactic acid in our muscles and we cannot continue. This is the overview of cellular respiration with a bit of anaerobic process fermentation. I'll be posting another video about the details in cellular respiration, so the details of every step. And I hope this was helpful, and thank you.